Today's March 18th, I think. Pretty close. Come here, Deets. Don't hit the camera.
Today's March, day after yesterday, which I think was the 16th, so that makes it the 17th. I got all the dogs again. I was gonna go down south, but I don't know. It just wasn't worth driving down there for it to get that hot. It's supposed to cool off next week, the middle of next week, so hopefully. Maybe there is something to this global warming thing. Maybe it's not man-made, but maybe it's just a shift in the climate or something. I don't know, because it sure seems awfully hot. Anyway, we're gonna go up, take the same route we usually take, just see if that lion came back through there. I don't know, it's nice and cool this morning. I mean, it's almost cold. But anyway, not a whole lot to say. Here we go.
We hit a lion track first thing this morning. It's about 7 o'clock or so. Man, I learned something good about Booger. I mean, when he hit that lion track, he let out a real slow old bawl. Just standing in one place man, they trailed up a canyon, and I went around, I intercepted them on top, and then I got to stay right with them the whole time. And
we started this track, oh, I don't know, probably about, I'm gonna say maybe half a mile, three quarters of a mile back there. I never found the track, but the broke dogs started it, and they moving it just right. We could be on the wrong end of it, but I got all the dogs with me, so I had some young dogs run off that direction. I popped them, and they came back. Anyway, that's old Jazz. She's really trying to go find it. Booger, Jazz, Sissy. That's about it, really. P, she came back to me. I have no idea why. Now, but she's with them now. I heard her open a couple times. Booger's the one who started it. I better get down there to him. Here we go.
It was good track. I'm a little confused whether we were on the right end of it or not. I thought I seen a track going the wrong way, but I wasn't 100% sure, so I didn't turn them around. P, come here. So I didn't turn them around. Jazz right here, she did a really good job.
Getting hot. I know if we don't get her jumped here pretty soon, we're gonna be done. These dogs have just trailed their hearts out. Maybe she's up in those bluffs. There they go, right up through there.
You know, 8 dogs on the track. 7 dogs, because Sheila puppy came back. But it was fun. We trailed, I don't know, we probably trailed 4 miles.
That lion's worked all these rims. Come right around through here. Shoot, we started way back off over in there somewhere on that other mountain. I keep thinking she bedded down in these rocks up here somewhere. Who knows for sure? I don't know how far behind, but we're not making any time now.
Back in there, and it got hot, you know. I got up into some pretty rough country, some big old boulder piles and stuff, but you know that they trailed good. They did a good job. The young dog stayed with them. Lori, come here, Lori. Lori, darling. She's tired. Too hot for a fire tonight. Deets didn't do any good. He didn't really want a cold trail. He went with him and he came back and he went with him and he came back. And then he was always, you could look on the Garmin or look and see, he was always out and about. You know, he wasn't causing any problems, but he sure wasn't helping with the trailing. Who else? Booger did the most work. P did a lot of work in some rough spots. Jazz did a good job.
Much as I hate to admit it, I think we were backwards on him. Her. I found a small track up there. It was all walked in. I thought I found the lobes, you know, the back, the W, whatever they want to call it, the three lobes on the back pad, but it looked like it was going the wrong way. You know, I've got 10 dogs out here. I had 8 of them, or 9 of them on the track at one time. So, and it looked like a little track, you know, maybe that big around, not a very big line at all. But the dogs did good. It's hot. I bet it's 75, almost 80 degrees right now.
Dan did a pretty good job. Dan the man. He opened and trailed a little bit. But anyway, it was good. You know what?
Right there's where they started that track this morning, right underneath that tree. And went up and over and down. I don't know. I bet they trailed a good 3 or 4 miles. Now they're tired. And Dietz went back to camp. He got off chasing a coyote or a deer or something.
I don't like to wear chaps. I hate to wear them. I got a pair of full chaps and I have these chinks. Come here, Maggie. And Maggie did a good job. And I, you know, the other day I was up. I was way back in some backcountry bushwhacking. And I've got some chaps that I wear, some made for a saw or a chainsaw. In case you know, they're supposed to, if you hit yourself with the chain, you know, it won't cut you. And you know, you got a big old artery right there in your leg that, man, if you sever that thing out there in the backcountry or whatever, you're done. I mean, you're just gonna bleed out. I don't think there's anything you can do. I mean, I guess you could tie a tourniquet or something, but more than likely, back this far, you're just gonna die. And the other night when I was riding out, I was bushwhacking through some pretty rough country. And like I said, I hate to wear chaps because you gotta get off and you gotta walk and, you know, and they are always in the way and they get hot or it's something else you gotta put on in the morning. But I had a branch, you know, that the mule gets in that brush and he just pushes his way through it. And I had one hit me right there. And it didn't puncture or anything. But I got to thinking, you know, if it would have been sharp, it's possible, you know, it could have hurt. So I decided I better start wearing these chinks or at least some chaps or something just for a little bit more protection. But anyway, look at these hound dogs. Booger. Come here, Booger. Come here, Booger. Your hands hurt? You're a pretty good boy. Jazz. P's always looking for attention. Anyway. That's it. I'm going home for the weekend. There we go.
When I was a young fella out here years ago in the summertime, I used to ride up into the high mountains, up out of the cactus and greasewood country, up past the cedars and pinons, up to them tall stands of yellow pine, tall enough to reach up and shake hands with their creator. And there was always little patches of snow laying around on the ground. Summertime. In the winter, I used to come down on the prairie. I had me a caveman. And I had me a woman.